So, dear students, today we will discuss the binary operations. In the last lecture, we defined binary operation. What is a binary operation? So, in last lecture, we see that a binary operation star is basically mapping from G cross G to G, and it means star of A comma B is equal to C. Here, naturally, A, B, C, they all belongs to G. And this notation usually written as A star B equal to C. Then we discuss the properties which a algebraic structure G comma star may have, that is associative, commutative, and existence of identity and existence of inverse. Then we taken few examples to understand the concept of binary operation. So today we will start with composite tables. These tables are helpful to check whether a binary operation holds the four properties or not. But these tables can be drawn in the case when G is finite. So now let us consider G is a finite set. Let's suppose G is finite set. So now to understand it, let us take an example. Now let us take a set G 1 minus 1 iota minus iota, and the algebraic structure is G dot. This dot is multiplication, usual multiplication, and we know that iota square is equal to minus 1. So the composite tables can be plotted. So to plot a composite table, what we will do, we make a table like this. We write the elements here, 1 minus 1, iota minus iota. Here is 1 minus 1, iota and minus iota. So to make this composite table, what we will do, we will apply this element with all of these with the operation dot. So 1 into 1, 1, 1 into minus 1, minus 1. 1 into iota, iota, 1 into minus iota, minus iota. So minus 1, plus 1, minus iota, iota. Now in case of iota, it is iota, minus iota. This will be iota square minus 1, minus iota square is 1. And minus iota, this is iota, minus iota, iota is 1, and minus iota is minus 1. So this is the composite table. So these tables are very useful. So first thing, with the help of these type of tables, we can check whether the operation is binary or not. So if we see this particular table, we can check this table contains only the elements of G. There is no element which does not belong to G. So this says that this operation dot, in this case, is a binary operation. So this is binary operation. Or we can say that this operation dot is closed under G. The second thing, with the help of this table, we can check whether the operator dot is a commutative in nature or not. So let's rewind. A operator star is said to be commutative if A star B is equal to B star A for all A comma B belongs to G. So this dot will be commutative if this matrix, is a symmetric one. Means if Aij is equal to Aji. So we can see here, this is the diagonal elements. These are the diagonal elements. And from here we can see minus 1, minus 1. This iota, iota. This minus iota, minus iota. Minus iota, minus iota. Iota with this iota and this one with this one. So this matrix is a symmetric matrix. So the first observation is that this dot is commutative. Now, the second thing, what we can do, we can find the identity element. So, how we find the identity element using composite tables? So, we will look for a row which is identical to the header row. हम वो रो देखेंगे जो हेडर रो से बिल्कुल आइडेंटिकल है. सो यू कैन सी हियर दिस रो, दिस फर्स्ट रो इज आइडेंटिकल टू हेडर रो. सो वी विल से दिस वन इज द आइडेंटिटी एलिमेंट. तो आइडेंटिटी एलिमेंट कैसा मिलेगा हमें? विल सी ए रो विच इज जस्ट आइडेंटिकल टू द हेडर रो एंड द कोरस्पोंडिंग एलिमेंट विल बी द आइडेंटिटी एलिमेंट. सो नेक्स्ट थिंग विच वी ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम दिस टेबल दैट इज वन इज आइडेंटिटी. Now, with the help of this particular table, we can also obtain the inverse of the elements. How? What we will do, in this table we will mark the identity element. So, here this is the identity element 1, here it is 1, so where it is 1 and here it is 1. So, what we will say, 1 is the inverse of 1, here it is 1, so minus 1 is the inverse of minus 1. Minus iota is the inverse of iota. And this iota is the inverse of minus iota. So basically what we are seeing, kya dekh rahe hum log? We are taking row and column. So this is the identity element. So minus iota ka inverse kya hoga? Iota hoga. To humne kya find kiya ki 1 ka inverse kya hai? 1. माइनस इनवर्स का इनवर्स क्या है? माइनस वन. आयोटा का इनवर्स क्या आया हमारे पास? आयोटा का इनवर्स था माइनस आयोटा. एंड माइनस आयोटा का इनवर्स क्या है? आयोटा. सो इन द केस वी हैव ए फाइनाइट सेट, वी कैन यूज कंपोजिट टेबल्स टू फाइंड वेदर दैट बाइनरी ऑपरेशन एग्जिस्ट और नॉट, और दैट इज ए क्लोज अंडर जी और नॉट. Second thing, we can check whether it is commutative, we can find the identity element, and we can find also the inverse of the elements. So let's move to the next part. Now we'll discuss two algebraic structures, the important algebraic structures which we will use in further lectures also. That is Zn. Let us see. So, when we study the set theory, in the set theory we say that we define a relation there. The relation is equivalent relation, that is A is congruent to B mod N. And this relation says this will happen, this is equivalent to basically N divides A minus B. So we will use the same mode. N divides A minus B means the remainder of A minus B when divided by N will be equal to 0. So first of all we define a set Zn. So we define a set Zn. This Zn will be 0, 1, 2 up to N. So this will be a finite set having n plus 1 elements. Now I define the two operations on it. The first one is addition. So first I take a algebraic structure Zn plus. Now this plus sign here means what is this operator plus, or if I take a comma b belongs to Zn, or let's take it n1 comma n2 belongs to Zn. So n1 plus n2 is the mod of n1 plus n2 comma n, and this mod is basically remainder. So what this operation is, it will give the value of the remainder when n plus 1 n plus n1 plus n2 is divided by n. So let's suppose to understand it, now let us say we have Z4. Now let's suppose we have a Z4. So in case of Z4, we have the element 0, 1, 2, and 3. Now let's we want to find the value of 1 plus 2. So what will be 1 by 1 plus 2? 1 plus 2 will be mod of 3 comma, it is 1 plus 2 comma 4. So it is the remainder when 1 plus 2 equal to 3 is divided by 4. What will be the value? The value will be only 3. Now let us see what is the value of 2 plus 3. So 2 plus 3 is mod of 2 plus 3 comma 4. So it is 5. 5 comma 4 se divide karenge, so kya remainder aayega? Remainder will be 1. And if we see 2 plus 2, though it will be mod of 4 comma 4, it comes to be 0. So what is the conclusion from here? What is this 3 basically? It 3 kaise hai hamare paas? When we this 2 plus 3 is 1. 2 plus 2 is 0. So now let us try to write this n1 plus n2 equal to mod of n1 plus n2 comma n in the simpler form. Now here we see that this 1 plus 2 is exactly 3 when 3 is less than 4. When this number is less than n. And in this case, this is 2 plus 3. In the case of 2 plus 3, it is 1. So it is basically 5 minus 4. Or you can say 2 plus 3 minus 4. And here it is 2 plus 2 minus 4. So this notation can also be written as n1 plus n2, just n1 plus n2. In the case n1 plus n2 is less than n, or otherwise it will be n1 plus n2 minus n. Otherwise means when n1 plus n2 is greater than or equal to n. So we can use the above definition. One in the case of remainder, another this one. So these two are one and the same. These two are one and same. So now let us try to draw a composite table for let's suppose Z5 or let's suppose Z7. Let us take Z7. Z7 is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So now let us try to write this table. So here we have plus. It will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here we again 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I think we can adopt it all. So it will be more visible to all students. So it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is 0, 1, 2, 3. So we have written this plus as plus is n1 plus n2 is equal to mod of n1 plus n2 comma n, or we have written it this will be n1 plus n2 if n1 plus n2 is less than n, otherwise it will be n1 plus n2 minus n. This is the case when n1 plus n2 is greater than or equal to. So we will use this relation. So 0 plus 0, 0. in this category, less than n. In this case, n is equal to, in this particular example, n is 7. So n1 plus n2, 0 plus 0, 0, less than 7, 0 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is a simple one. All the elements are less than 7, so the exact value will be come. Now in the case of 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now 1 plus 6 is 7, so it will become 7 equal to 7, so it will be n1 plus n2 minus n. So 7 minus 7, it will be equal to 0. Then 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now 2 plus 5, 7. So 7 minus 7 again equal to 0. 2 plus 6, 8. So 8 minus 7 is equal to 1. Similarly for 3, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now 3 plus 4, 7. 7 minus 7, 0. 3 plus 5, 8, 1, 3 plus 6, 9, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 means 0, 4 plus 4, 8, 1, 4 plus 5, 9, 2, 4 plus 6, 10, same here 5, 6, 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, in the case of 6, it will be 6, 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this will be a composite table. This is a composite table. Now, the first observation. We have taken Z7. So over Z7 will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So from here we can clearly see all elements are present here. The elements are from 0 to 6 only. So this plus operation is closed under Z7. So this plus is a binary operation. This is the first finding. So this plus is a binary operation. The plus is binary operation. We have checked. Now to check whether it is a associative or not, you can see whether it is a symmetric or not. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, this 4, 4, again 3 to 3, 4 to 4, 5 to 5, 5 to 6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, this is symmetric matrix. So, since the matrix is symmetric, so plus is commutative also. Kyo commutative hua? Because this matrix is a symmetric matrix. Then, identity element, we can see here. This is 0, this 0, these two, this row is identical with this row, so it means these two rows are identical, so it means 0 is identity element. So 0 is identity element. Now to find the inverse, what we will do, we will mark all the identity elements in the table. So from here what we can see, 1 ka inverse can, the inverse of 1 is 6. The inverse of 2. 2 ki case mein 0 kaha rahi, 5 ki corresponding. 2, 5. Similarly, you can see for 3 it is 4. For 4 it is 3. For 5 it is 2. And for 6 it is 1. So, in this way we can find the inverse. And from here we can generalize about Zn. So, Zn plus. What we can say about Zn plus? First thing, this plus will be a binary operation. Number two, plus is a commutative in nature. Number three, the identity element of this will be 0. Now, if we talk about the inverse, we can see the inverse is, in this case, 6 is 7 minus 1. Here's 7 minus 2. Here's 7 minus 3. Here's 7 minus 4. 7 minus 5 and 7 minus 1. So we can say the inverse of n1 is n1 minus n minus n1. So this is our Zn plus table. Similarly, we can talk about the another algebraic system, that is Zn top. We'll take quickly that one. So the next one is Zn dot. Here again Zn is the same. So in case this dot, now the n1 dot n2 is mod of n1 n2 comma n. So in this case we will find the remainder when we are dividing n1 into n with n. So now let's suppose we are taking Z5 only. Now take Z7. Now let us take Z5. So in Z5 we will have element 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So now the operation is dot. So it will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 because multiplication 0, 0, 0, 0. Now, 1 it will be multiplied by 1, it will be 0, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 2, 2, 1 into 3, 3, 1 into 4, 4. Because all the terms are less than 5, so the remainder will remain same. When we multiply it with 2, it is 0, 2, 1, 2, 4. Now, 2 into 3, 6. So, 6, 5 ka remainder kya hoga? 1. 2 into 4, 8. 8, 5 ka remainder kya hoga? 3. 3 into 0, 0. 3 into 1, it will be 3. 3 into 2, 6. 6, 5, it will be 1. 3 into 3, 9. 9, 5 will be 4. 3 into 4, 12. 12, 5 more will be 2. When we take 4, 0. 4, 1, 4, 4 to 8, 8, 5 will be 3, 4 into 3, 12, 12, 5, again it will be 2, 4 into 4, 16, 16, 5, it will be 1. So, this is the composite table of Z5 with multiplication. So, from here what we can see, this is a diagonal table, this is a diagonal elements. So let's check whether it is as commutative or not. 2 and 2, 0, 0 are same. 3, 3, 0, 0 same. 4, this is here is 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 2. So yes, the two things are clear. Number one, dot under Z5, because all elements belong to Z5 only. Then second thing we have seen, this dot is commutative. Now let us find the identity element. Let us see the row which is identical with the header row. So is there any row which is identical to the header row? Yes. This row is the identical one. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 is the identity here. One is the identity here. Now let us find the inverse. To find the inverse, we have to mark the 1. So here it is 1, here it is 1, here it is 1. And there is no other 1. So the inverse of 0 does not exist. Because in this row we have no 1. So inverse of 0 does not exist. The second thing, the inverse of 2 will be 3, the inverse of 3 will be 2, the inverse of 4 will be 4. So the inverse of 2 is 3, 3 is 2 and 4 is 4. So this is the example of Zn, dot, in which n1 dot n2 means the mod of n1 into n, n. So here we see that we have one element 0, whose inverse does not exist. Thank you. It's all for today. Thank you very much.